there. In this class, we are going to learn how to print using foam sheets. And we will print something really good on these cards. Let's see what all art supplies we need for this project. We will need some envelopes, foam sheets. These are easily available in any art stores. Some cardstock papers, any colors of your choice. Ruler, some sharpies, pencil and a brush, we will need a paper cutter, or if you don't have one, you can use a scissor to cut the papers. A mixing palette and a paper towel. And some clean water in a jar. Now that we have all our art supplies, let's get started. I'm going to make two cards. For that, cut 7.5 by 5 inches sheet of any color cardstock paper. I'm using a thank you card, which is like 7.5 by 5 inches. I'm gonna trace the card, thank you card onto the cardstock and then cut it. Using my paper cutter to cut the cardstock. You can use a scissors if you don't have a paper cutter. So you can use a normal scissor if you don't have a paper cutter. I want to cut a different color paper of same size. So I want to choose pink color cardstock. And then I'll just take this size and cut it. Thank you. the papers ready. And now let's fold them into half. These cards fit perfectly into the envelope. Are ready, and now let's use the foam sheets to make the design and print it onto the cards. Cut out a foam sheet that fits perfectly onto the card. It should be in a square shape. And now let's cut out some more foam sheets of the same size, since we are making two cards. I have already traced the sizes. Now we can just cut them. Sheets generally don't produce sharp details, but they are easy to make good basic prints. Before you begin, sketch out your design on the foam sheet. I am going to draw some small gifts and some balloons on this foam sheet. You should apply more pressure when you are drawing on the foam sheet. And you should also note that your sheet will print the mirror image of your drawing. A lot of times, this doesn't matter. But if you're printing letters, you have to flip the letters before etching your sheet. Thank you. The paint will not penetrate these marks when you apply the paint onto this foam sheet. So you will get negative lines when you print. So just apply the paint onto this foam sheet until you get even coverage. Now carefully place the sheet where you want it on your paper. Gently roll or apply pressure with your hands over the sheet. And then carefully lift up the foam sheet to reveal your print. You can experiment this with more than two colors also. Now let's print on the other card. I am using a paint roller here. I'm applying some paint onto the roller. Now roll the paint onto the foam sheet until you get even coverage. I'm adding some more paint. And now carefully place this sheet where you want onto your card. Now apply pressure with your hand over the sheet. And then carefully lift up the foam sheet to reveal the print. It is a great way for children to make prints of their choice, and you might be surprised at the results you can get with a little experiments. The great thing about this artwork is that you can create your own greeting cards, gift boxes, wrapping papers, and even cake decorations.
Thank you.
cards with your own prints for your friends and families can be an enjoyable hobby. Taking the time to make greeting cards personally lets the receiver know how special they are to you. I really enjoyed making these cards and I hope you will too. Thanks for watching.